I'm a strawberry breeder, and what we do is develop new varieties for North Carolina growers, and actually the whole region as well. The main focus of the research here of the strawberry breeding program is to develop disease resistance. So in North Carolina, as we all know, it gets hot in the summer and we have lots of diseases, you know, through the spring and also through the winter and the fall. So what we're trying to do is develop varieties that are adapted to North Carolina and that can tolerate these diseases. The two varieties that we use right now that are the primary ones that growers plant are Camarosa and Chandler. They're over 30 years old, they're from California, and they have no disease resistance. Although growers love them, the public loves them, but every year we see, you know, significant losses on different fields and different farms to some of the diseases that are common out there. Well, so I actually just took over this program about 4 years ago, but we have two selections, we call them, that, you know, they have an NC number that we think we're going to release, and we have those out with farmers this year, and we had them out last year, and we're getting some feedback from them, and so if we get positive feedback from them, we'll have two new varieties that we'll name and release here from the program, so that's exciting. And then the next step is to develop some disease resistance as well, so it's fun. It's great working with the growers. They ground you. They make sure that you're doing what they need you to do, and that we make sure that they like what we like, because oftentimes I'll see something in the field and I'll say, oh, it's got great yield and big berry size, and they're like, yeah, but it doesn't really hold up well in the rain, or it does hold up well in the rain, and it, you know, they'll notice things that I don't necessarily look at or screen for. You know, some of the selections here do really well in the eastern part of the state because they have a good plant canopy that shades the plant or the fruit when it gets really hot and sunny out. And about half the growers are these small growers with, you know, 1 to 3 acres, or maybe even more than half of them, but they, you know, they have quite a few acres. And then we have some larger growers that have 10 to, you know, 100 acres. So it's kind of a mix. And there's actually a distinction between the small guys that have the pick your own, guys and gals, actually, because there's lots of women strawberry growers out there, and then also the larger ones that have the, you know, so there's, and they actually have two different types of strawberries that they want to grow too, so we try to keep everybody happy here. they're just so good, you know, they're the first thing to come out in the spring, you know, coming out of winter, it's just a fun crop to eat, and they're locally grown, you know, California's a long way away, you know, for a lot of these strawberries to be shipped, so the flavor's getting better, you know, some of the companies are doing better on their development of flavors, but for sure, a fresh picked, right straight out of the field strawberries can't be beat.
Miss Bobby on TV.
He's got the best strawberries. They're real sweet and juicy. Mmm. Mmm. That's good.